Hello, everybody. We didn't expect to be making this video this quickly after our earlier one.
It's been an eventful day.
It's been a very eventful day.
It's Santa. He's giving us a bunch of presents for Christmas.
Yep, Santa's real, guys. So
it's amazing. We've all been good this year.
Thanks to Dimitri.
JK, Santa's not real. Ha 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 ha.
Ouch. Thanks to Dimitri on Eurobricks. He has delivered us a proposed list of BIONICLE Summer 2015 set names that I initially did not believe were legitimate, and I guess we really still don't have any proof either way, but based upon some searches I've ran that I will explain in a minute, I do believe they're legit. But without further ado, let's get into the names. We have Skull Warrior, Skull Slicer, Skull Basher, Skull Scorpio, or Scorpion, that may be a typo, but probably Scorpio. And Mask Maker versus Skull Grinder. That's it. All villains plus a Mask Maker.
So we're basically going to have a Kimu and then...
Yeah, so we got a whole wave of villains with a plus a Kimu and Mask of Creation. Obviously, that's five villain sets. And if you count Lord of Skull Spiders, that's our typical 6 versus 6 wave of villains versus heroes.
Yep.
So
it all balances
standard
out.
Standard BIONICLE. Yep. Very interesting names. Something to take note out of them, I guess, is that they are referring to Akimu as Mask Maker in the set form. Now we already know that the sets refer to the Toa as Masters on the box art, but in actuality, they are in fact referred to the Toa in the story. So it's possible that these aren't the same names that they will be referred to in the story as well. Unsure, unlikely, who knows?
Well, it's definitely, like, that's the whole reason they're doing the Masters thing. It's because it's easier to market that term, and the dedicated fans that actually follow the story, they can delve more in depth to what they're actually called.
Yeah, which is why Akimu's Mask Maker.
Yeah. So this is obviously very interesting, a skull-themed wave, which obviously makes me very happy.
Yeah, you must be in heaven right now, Messi.
I am indeed. This is quite amazing. There was actually a rumor a while back on Tumblr. I didn't really believe it at the time, but it may be validated a little bit by this. Someone named Dandazil said he has sources that indicate the summer 2015 sets will be a few skeleton-themed villains with glow-in-the-dark pieces.
Dandazil's a well-known mocker in the community, I do so believe.
Yep. So. Unless he's just making a joke, which is very possible. Hey.
It looks like that's exactly what we're getting. Skull-themed everything.
The Basher, the Slicer, the Grinder.
It sounds
I don't
like
know how to feel
awful,
about these names.
Sounds like a ripoff or a Slap Chop commercial.
Sounds like Power Ranger villains.
Sounds like Paraka code names.
Oh my goodness.
The Warrior, the Slicer, the Basher, the Scorpio, the Grinder.
Yo, yo, Paraka, Skull Rocka.
Yo, yo, Skull Rocka.
Skull Rocka, Skull Rocka.
We've reached a new low.
Yeah.
I hope one of the two of you get coal for Christmas.
Ouch.
Wow, that's not nice. So I've already gotten a new one.
Here's the deal. The guy who posted this, Dimitri, he's never posted anything related to leaks on Eurobricks before. Okay, he's a longtime user, but not a longtime leaker. Today is his first posting, and he posted this, and he posted City. And obviously people asked and were like, well, can you provide a source for these so we can... you know, I actually believe these because they seem rather odd. And he posted that he saw the list at an import company that is same as City 2H list reveal today. And what he's referring to is he also posted the list of the City 2015 sets. However, Just Too Good has been posting those as well. So obviously, if you were going under the assumption that they were faked, one could easily say, well, he just took Just Too Good's list and repurposed it as his own. However, What he then posted, I guess as an attempt to further validate, were several other set lists, including City Spaceport, Minecraft, and Exploration. Now, Minecraft is just too good, already revealed that, so that's another thing which kind of could count against his favor, assuming they were faked. As far as the spaceport, I actually don't know. I think that's exclusive to him, but I'm not sure. The big deal, the really big deal, is a new theme called Exploration. I think it's a new theme, maybe a sub-theme. And he posted a couple sets from Exploration, and what I did was I ran the set numbers through Google, found the cache page on that Eurotoys website that I was talking about earlier for Bionicle, and one that I doubt he would be able to find and repurpose all the numbers and give them names to make them sound plausible if it was an elaborate hoax. And the set numbers check out. Their actual set numbers coming. So, based on that long-winded explanation, I think they're real.
Obviously, there's still room for it to have been faked, correct, but it just doesn't seem very likely that he would have faked them from what's been presented to us, as well as his obvious, I guess he's been using the forums for a while now, so he's been around the community for a while now, so it always seems weird that a person who has been a part of the community would lie about leaking.
Yeah. Doesn't really do you much service.
Yeah, usually when someone's lying about leaking, they're usually already not very popular amongst the community, or they're randoms that no one's ever heard of.
Yeah, or there's some little kid making a joke. This dude's very active in Technic circles, which kind of gives you the implication he's probably older and not prone to pranks and stuff.
So, obviously, as with the initial Bionicle 2015 leaks that we got back in October, take it with a grain of salt. Be a bit skeptical, just to be safe. But it seems like they may be legitimate, so feel free to let your speculatory brains work.
Yep.
Wait.
And get your theories going. What?
Did you say the leaks we got back in October?
I mean, yeah, you're right. February.
You remember when you guys are at New York? Yeah, those leaks were July. Pretty major.
Yep.
Shut up.
I'm
thinking about our major dates where we got major information. October and then July were the major dates. So
July was like a whirlwind of stuff.
Oh yeah.
But no, it's like this is at first I was kind of off, put off by it because of the generic sounding names. But I don't know. I understand what they're trying to do for marketing purposes.
Honestly, I've got no clue what to expect yet, because when we initially got our first leaks of the names, I thought they were really stupid too, Skull Spiders and Lord of Skull Spiders, but now that we actually have the sets coming out now, I really don't care that much, and I think the sets look cool, so I guess I'm going to wait and see. Yeah. Right now, I'm not a big fan of the names, but they've proven that they're capable so far, so I'm going to wait and see what the sets look like.
Yeah. There's a statue in Pohatu's character video that's like a warrior with a scorpion-esque theme with a tail, I think. People are theorizing that's one of these sets.
I'd bank money on it being Skull Warrior.
Probably. Just a small troop.
I mean, it might not necessarily be the same as the set, but obviously it definitely leads credence to the theory.
Yeah. Unfortunately, one theory it does not lead credence to is my Makuta and Akimu double pack.
Well, I mean, someone was speculating that Skull Grinder is just another name for Makuta.
Lame.
Well,
yeah. I mean, it would be lame, but they are calling Akimu by his code name as well instead of his name. Yeah. So, you never know.
Quite true. Well, regardless, you have names. Should not be too much longer until we get pictures, if history repeats anytime from a week to end of January.
At this rate, we'll just see you guys in a few hours.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
We'll be back.
I almost have to wonder if these names just sound way cooler in, like, Denmark than they do here.
Probably.
What is, Danish? Yeah. I imagine they probably sound way cooler in Danish than they do in English.
Yeah.
Sound kind of lame in English, but we'll see.
Just a little bit. But yeah, thank you guys for listening. That's pretty much all the news we have to bring you at this given moment. But stay tuned. We're going to be reporting on stuff as it happens. I love leak season.
Yeah. Only because you actually have something to do, Mr. I don't like to work ever at all.
You're right. This is where I shine. We'll see you guys next time for the next exciting video, and have a very Merry Christmas.
Yay, Christmas! Happy holidays!
Var, I swear every time.